The podcast you are listening to of Holmberg's Morning Sickness is brought to you by my friends at Eric's Family Barbecue in Avondale. Meet, mesquite, repeat. Trust me on this one. You've had barbecue before, but you haven't had it this good. Eric's Family Barbecue in Avondale, ericsfamilybbq.com.
Eric's Family Barbecue has arrived and is simply the best barbecue in Arizona. Come satisfy your taste buds with meats that are smoked over mesquite wood and sides that are made with fresh ingredients and tons of love. They have the best, juiciest brisket, pulled pork, rib, sausage, turkey, or everyone's favorite, the Pitmaster Sampler that includes all the meat and four sides, mac and cheese, potato salad, coleslaw, corn, or beans, yum. And for dessert, try some creamy banana pudding, amazing. Eric's Family Barbecue in Avondale, meat, mesquite, repeat. Make the trip, you won't be sorry. Dine in or take it to go, go to Eric's Family BBQ.com for more info.
This makes me think of that poor fish. Yeah, fish that had the case of the twisties at the end of this video. There is rumor, and Joe Rogan brought this up too, evidently about the Simone Biles thing, going back to that for a second. And I read it yesterday, and I'm like, I don't know how real that is, and it keeps popping up today, so there might be some smoke and fire in this. But evidently in Japan, a lot of mood-altering, I don't even know what they call those, like nootropics and things like that, that chemically change your brain for psychological use or for mental health issues, are illegal in Japan. And Ritalin is one of them. And she evidently has it, so she's not allowed to possess Ritalin in Japan. You still have to go by their laws, right?
Really, but if that's it. The case, the team should have known that, right? And said, look, you can't, we're not going to hold a spot on the team for you.
Exactly, and there'd be no harm in right. It was like when Ryan Clark of the Steelers couldn't go to Denver and play because he had sickle cell.
Yeah.
And he's like, you just can't play there. Like, we know an important game goes up in Denver, Ryan can't do it because he risks a lot of problems with that, and like he knows it. He's got an illness that makes it so he can't be in high altitude. So they knew that, and it's not like if you have Ritalin and you need it and you're not allowed to have it, why wouldn't they just say she can't come because she has to be on this?
Right, because there are athletes sitting there waiting in the wings to go, and they got screwed.
If there is truth to that, there's a lot of oddness in saying, oh, she's got mental health things, instead of saying, I'm not allowed to have Ritalin in Japan. I gave it a shot. I need my meds. I'm sick and I can't be here. Okay.
Even though it's medical reason, she can't.
Yeah, even in Japan, that's one of the things. Even if it's medical.
Say you can use Concerta in Japan. Ritalin is available in Japan to treat sleep disorders.
Right, but it's not
for mental.
It's not
prescribed
for
ADHD. Right.
And they will not allow you to have it.
Concerta's different. My son's on some of those medications. Oh, is he? And Concerta's different. It does different things.
So I don't know if there's reality to that with the Biles thing. Then it seems natural to just say, well, she's not allowed to have her medicine here. So it affected her, and it's real. And instead of just saying, oh, I have the twisties or I've got a medicine, just say, look, I'm not allowed to have my meds in Japan, and it messed me up.
It sounds worse for her saying it that way.
It now
sounds
like a
quitter.
Yeah.
I'm a quitter.
And now it sounds like I'm grabbing straws. I don't know. But, yeah, Rogan brought that up, too, so it got a lot of legs. But I read that a little bit yesterday, and I'm like, we'll see. Anyway, the whole thing is the whole thing's got the twisties, Brady.
Sure does.
I hope I'm fortunate enough someday to pass on from the twisties. It sounds fun. It's like the chubby checker of diseases. Let's twist it again.
He started it. Got into everyone's mind.
He gave us all the twisties right away. It does make me think of Twizzlers, too, because my brain, I'm a child.
The Beatles.
A little bit.
But the yips are a real thing, man.
Twist and shout. The yips are incredibly
real.
The
yips are a real thing. I've seen it in person.
Well, that's why support psychology exists, is because guys get the yips. We've got to figure out what's wrong with your melon.
John Lester. Great pitcher.
Can't throw to first base.
Had to leave it in his glove and throw his glove over.
He had to walk it over
and hand
it
to Andrew
grounded. He could not throw a ball to first base.
But he could throw a strike at 93 miles an hour wherever he wants.
Any other base.
Yeah.
It was the weirdest thing in the world to watch. And guys, it's the craziest thing if you ever watched a John Lester game when he'd pitch. Guys on first base would take like 15-foot leads, and he would not
throw there.
Because he knew, I can't do it.
Then Contreras just started picking people off, so they stopped doing that.
It's crazy. So yips are very real. Anyway, so Steve Byrne did this with his goddamn Yankee hat. It's time for the entertainment drill. It's brought to you by our friends at ReactDefense.com, the home of Tactical Black. And you know who doesn't care about your mental health or your yips or anything else? Somebody with bad intentions. You're not going to be able to go, hey, I got the twisties today. Please don't steal my wallet. Or I got the twisties today. Try not to beat me up here in the parking lot and take my car. Those are those moments where you're like, yeah, you better be prepared and know what's coming. And the self-defense system up there of Tactical Black is unmatched, unbelievable, and will get you in a place where you don't have to be all fired up and anxious because you have something in your tool belt that you know you can lean on when stuff goes pear-shaped. And that's all that we're looking for in the world is, when is this idiot going to do? How many times a day do you look over and go, what's this asshole up to? That's what tactical black stops. You're like, oh, God, okay, I got an eyeball over there. Keeps your head on a swivel for a good reason and makes you prepared, not paranoid. And there's a difference. Don't be a victim. They teach you how to do all the things that make you look like somebody nobody wants to bother. And that's it. Not that you're tough guying or bowing up to everybody, but just you look confident. And that's one thing bad guys do not deal with is a confident person. They'll give you that and more. You'll get in great shape doing it as well. Check it out, reactdefense.com, the home of Tactical Black. Brady Entertainment.
Donald Trump is selling one of his personal helicopters.
Just one of them, Brady. I've got several. I'm only selling one. I'm only going to get you
one. Give him an offer.
Yeah, fire it up. What do you got, Brett? What's in your pocket right now? What's in your wallet, I like to say. What do you got?
I don't know how much Capital One allowed me to throw on my card.
You know
but
I'll give it. You know what? Take it from me. Go into debt. It's okay. You can go into debt and buy great things and make, you know, you just make
claim
debt
bankruptcy
work
and come
yeah,
back.
Exactly. You get the bankruptcy. It's a great, great process. You know, I'm not doing anything wrong. How much do you want to pay me for my helicopter?
$500,000.
Absolutely.
You know
ridiculous.
What? You might be in the running.
Ridiculous.
It's a, come on, T. 1990?
It's a former president's goddamn helicopter. $500,000 is ridiculously low offer. American money? You're insane.
It's a 1990 Sikorsky S-76B.
That's classy. A commie.
And they usually around $1 million.
I got it from my friend, Pooty Poot Putin. He gave it to me for a few favors. It was pretty great. It's got some urine stains in it. There's no big deal about that. That just came from the prostitutes in the first flight. It's a 90. It's a classic Sikorsky.
It's pretty sweet.
Of course it is, Brady. It's a personal helicopter.
Really nice.
Tell me the last time you looked at a personal helicopter and said, this one sucks. They're all sweet. You've got your own chopper. You're doing all right. It's commie-copter, whatever. It's still more than you've got. You'd true. Take it. If somebody dropped off a commie-copter with a hammer and sickle on it and said, Brett, this is yours, you'd take it.
The
would
other
you,
thing.
If what? Somebody dropped off a Soviet Union, you know, decked out hammer sickle flag on the side and it said Brett Vesely's private ride, would you keep it?
Oh, yeah, why not?
Me too.
Oh, yeah.
I don't care. Taliban could get me a helicopter. I'd be like, thanks, guys.
I'll start singing their national anthem. I don't give a crap.
Give me a bottle of Smirnoff, and I'm ready to roll.
I'm rooting for Drago now, next time I watch Rocky IV.
If he dies, he dies.
Here's your helicopter, and congratulations for being the biggest sellout in American history. Good job, Benedict.
Another piece of history will be sold in about 2 weeks on the auction block. A 40-year-old piece of wedding cake.
There's a from Seinfeld Prince episode Charles about that.
And Diana's wedding.
No kidding. Yeah, because Peterman bought a John F. Kennedy, Jackie O piece of cake, and Elaine accidentally ate it.
The slice is from one of the 23 cakes that were made for the ceremony. Wow. Comes with a wedding program, ceremony details, and a breakfast menu. It last sold in 2008 for...
$2
million? $700.
What? This cake is changing hands?
Oh, yeah. No, this is a big thing.
Are you serious?
Wedding stuff. They save a piece for this kind of stuff at a lot of these giant weddings.
The hell's wrong with people?
I'd own it. That would be amazing.
For what?
Piece of history.
Put it where Rizzo's...
Look in my fridge.
Put it where Rizzo's
look
picture
in my fridge.
Used to hang. No, I'd have a little refrigerated box where Rizzo and Megan's painting used to hang.
Oh, yeah. You got to front down now, huh?
All right, Dahmer. Yeah.
That's a Dahmer move?
Yeah. I'm just going to keep it in the fridge.
He kept his in the freezer.
Yes. I wouldn't get
excuse me.
That's totally different than body parts.
Yeah, it's not,
although,
it's not a piece from the crash.
I would also take...
This is the right calf from...
The bullet fragments from Dallas. I'm not putting those up. I'm just, well, though I would.
Nah, that'd actually be kind of cool.
Oh, I'd frame those.
I'd frame that too.
Would you use that?
Well, because your people did it.
Well, look what they did when Lincoln.
Whoa.
Lincoln's assassination.
The hat.
At the home. They're cutting up the clothes.
Yeah.
You still see
little
those
squares
parts
of that?
Yeah.
The cake is, you know, that's kind of a thing. It's valuable. That's why I'd have it. Not because I'm so nostalgic about the Die Charles wedding.
Do then someone have a piece from the car, you know, the Mercedes in Paris. Like
good
they
Christ.
Scrapped it.
Nobody
I bet
some rappers wearing the Mercedes logo around his neck
look,
in Paris.
Somebody, there are vultures who go to those sites and grab. Yeah, there's no question.
Here's some wild purchases made by celebrities. Nicolas Cage. Heard a bunch of his, but
hit me, baby girl. Talk about my castle.
He spent almost $300,000 on a dinosaur skull.
Yeah.
Before returning it to Mongolia because it turned out to be stolen.
Right.
And then he did buy a castle in Germany.
That was real.
And his latest, the most recent one was the LaLaurie Mansion in New Orleans.
I thought he was broke.
It was haunted.
I am. It's amazing. I can still do this. My most amazing purchase of the last few was that little Chinese baby girl out of that sushi restaurant. She became my bride. Want a piece of cake?
Yeah.
I've got extra.
Spent $150K on the first Superman comic.
Yeah!
Mike Tyson bought a $2 million 24-karat gold bathtub for his wife at the time.
Who makes that?
That's a power move, man.
That is a power
move. That's a boss move right there.
Kanye and Kim, wow. They furnished their Bel Air mansion with four gold-plated toilets for $750K.
And now he's living in a small locker room with a bed on the floor.
In Atlanta.
Oprah bought a marble and onyx bathtub that is molded to the shape of her body.
It's a big bathtub.
Which body?
It's a big bathtub.
That's a spa. Stedman should be able to get in that, but... It's also Stedman's lap pool.
Kim Basinger bought a whole Georgia town in 1989. You remember that?
She got $20 million, too, right?
With the intention of making a tourist destination. Yeah. Not sure what.
Julie Roberts did something similar to that too.
Miley Cyrus bought a Range Rover just to take her dogs in because they weren't allowed in her other cars.
Right. You get a dog car.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Everybody with dogs has a car the dogs are allowed in, and the one that nobody can, you can't have it in.
Scarlett Johansson is suing Disney, claiming their decision to release Black Widow when the box office was still weak, and also put it on Disney Plus because she gets producer rights on the film, and part of that deal is a profit sharing.
Right.
She's saying since they added it to the stream early. And it wasn't a mass, you know, release in theaters only.
She lost some dough.
Yeah.
Which is reasonable
to
think.
She got paid $20 million just for playing the part of Black Widow.
Because if you're going to pay $30 for that early access, then you're going to go see the movie.
That's what I think. Well,
so she's got a point.
But if you're in the Disney Plus world, that's kind of on her for not negotiating that in the beginning.
I think that was before. This movie's been in the works, and they didn't know about the Disney Plus.
They didn't tell her. Well, bottom line is then she's got a bad agent who didn't know about streaming services. Because basically it would be Hulu or Netflix, and those existed. So it'd be like, if it goes to this too fast, we need money.
But nobody knew they were going to take new release big movies and premiere them online.
At the time, it was signed up as just the theatrical release.
But also, $20 million is a lot, so stop whining.
Well, I don't know that,
But Disney is saying...
I don't get in her pockets on that, because that's a good deal.
I am. That's ridiculous.
I know. It's a lot of money.
Finally, this is amazing. The Rick Roll. Rick Astley's Never Gonna Give You Up.
Yeah.
Just hit the 1 billion mark on YouTube. 1 billion views.
Good for you, Rick. It's still funny.
Man's a legend.
It's still funny when it catches you and you don't know what's happening. You're like, I just got Rickrolled. And you can't help it.
What year do you think that started?
The Rickrolling?
Yeah.
Early 2000s, probably.
Yeah, like 2006.
YouTube.
I was going to say mid-2000s.
Yeah, that's about right.
2009.
Yeah. It's 12 years of Rickrolling, but a billion. That's amazing. Well, there you go. Thanks, Rick Astley. Who knew that would be his career?
And that he leans into it and embraces it is amazing.
He loves it. He went on with the Foo Fighters when they covered it, and he popped up on stage with them. It was hilarious. Yeah, wouldn't you?
Absolutely.
I would be all over that. And my Taliban helicopter eating that cake from Princess Diana's wedding. I'd have to take a bite of it. That would be my problem. I couldn't have Brady over ever again if I had that cake.
Ooh, cake. Ooh, there's a cake in this.
Come on, bro.
Break out with a little. We'll reshape it.
No, Brady, don't eat the cake.
It's only 40 years old.
Save the icing.
Would you eat it?
I'd take a bite.
I'd probably take
a
slug of it.
That's disgusting. You got a problem. You're a glutton. All right. It's Friday already. We got the Guadalupe Squares coming up in just moments. We need a girl. We need a boy. We've got tickets to SmackDown, I believe.
Sure.
Why not?
We'll find them. We'll get you something.
God, I love having an Italian on the show. I get some.
You're going to get some.
You get some. A man who gets
things. Don't worry about it.
You want SmackDown tickets? How about I get you in the ring?
I'll hear Randall running down here now.
Yeah. We don't have any SmackDown.
I got it.
You're going to get Brett Vesley SmackDown.
I got this. Don't worry about it.
Get you some. But if you want to play, Brett will get you something. That's our prize pack today. I need a girl, need a guy. The squares are coming up next. There goes your entertainment drill.
Hey, it's not weird. It's pretty cool, actually. No membership fee.
I have heard enough of this.
You've been listening to Holmberg's Morning Sickness Podcast, brought to you by our friends at Eric's Family Barbecue in Avondale. Meet, mesquite, repeat. Eric's FamilyBBQ.com.